Dear brothers and sisters, it's wonderful to have an opportunity to be able to talk to so many of you as we all tune into this broadcast. We're all going through a very difficult period with the pandemic spreading all around the globe. The difficulty is not with just one family or one society or one country. Billions of people have been affected by the virus, and collectively the challenges to each and every one of us are getting more and more and more. How do we deal with the challenges, and can we take a challenge and turn it into an opportunity? If we look back at history, we find that we as human beings have been facing all kinds of challenges, and we use those challenges to invent things, to come up with new systems, and to do things which would help us get over that challenge. If we look at many, many, many years ago, this was even before we as human beings had found out about fire. There was only the light coming from the sun, and at night it would be dark, and there was no mechanism of being able to live properly in those times which were very, very dark. And so human beings found out about fire, and with the fire came light. And as light came in, people could live much more safely at night. And then when we look at the old times, people would walk from one place to another. And then they started to use the animals like horses or camels to take them from one place to another. And it would take many, many days to get from one area to another. And so human beings invented the wheel so that they could go much, much faster. And not only did they invent the wheel, with time, they started to use energy and came up with automobiles and buses and cars and trains so that we could be transported from one place to another very, very quickly. And as human beings wanted to go to other parts of the world, along came the invention of the aeroplane, so that we could fly to another part of the world very, very quickly, get to know their cultures and get to be able to understand them better and to be able to do trade with them. And then, as time went by, we wanted faster aeroplanes, so the jet planes came in, and then came the airships, the ones which could go beyond the atmosphere of the earth. And we as human beings were able to put a person on moon. And just recently, after a lot of research, human beings have been able to put a rover on Mars, and through that also mechanism by which what is happening on that planet could be sent back here, so pictures of that planet be made available to us. And if we just think about the last year, look at how much research would have gone by researchers and scientists and doctors and people from the medical arena to come up with a number of vaccines to deal with this pandemic. And today, as we think about the difficulties that the virus has brought to us, we also know that the vaccines are available, so that as more and more people get vaccinated in different parts of the world, that we would be going back to a life which would be similar to what we had before the pandemic came to hit everyone all around the globe. It's hard to imagine what would have happened if no vaccine would have come out. And so things that took 7 or 8 or 9 years to develop, because vaccines take a long time to be developed, and there have been other vaccines which have been developed over the years to be able to deal with other diseases. But to think of it being developed in just a year, and the help that it is providing to deal with the challenge, is definitely something to marvel at. We as human beings have always innovated. Gone are the times when people would only use wood and stone as tools. And look at how they use the tools that they made out of the stones and the wood to create things like the pyramids. And so challenges have been coming one after another in life, but opportunities have also been made out of the challenges by human beings. Today, as we look at the difficult state that we might be in ourselves, we might have some family members who are fighting the virus, either at home or in the hospitals. We might have lost our dear one to the virus. And we know that there have been tremendous amount of difficulties in the physical arena, in the emotional arena, in the mental arena, that we all have to deal with during the last few months. We need to dig deep into ourselves and see if a challenge is there and we are unable to change the environment or the outside which is producing that challenge, how do we deal with the situation? We need to look at ourselves and see, can we change ourselves to deal with that challenge better? I like to relate a very high-powered example. This is a true example. This is from the life of a young girl. There was a young girl who was born in a very poor family. The family was very big. They had 22 children in that family, and she was the 20th one. She was born prematurely. And because she was born prematurely, the doctors and the nurses told the parents that she might not live. Her mother nourished her well, and she did live. She was very weak, she was very frail, but she did live. And when she was 4 years old, the scarlet fever was rampant at that time. And in that process, her left leg got paralyzed. So the doctor said she'll never be able to walk normally. And they gave her a brace so that she could go from one place to another. But her mother was always encouraging her. And she was trying to encourage her to get up and try to walk, to go from one place to another, to be able to do chores that other kids would do also. And the mother was always encouraging her so that whatever she wished, she should be able to do that. And so with a lot of exercise and a lot of help that she got, you know, from the doctors and the nurses at the time, When she was 9 years old, she could take her brace off and she took her first step. As she took her first step, the encouragement for her family was there, and slowly, 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 she started to take other steps. She would wobble and she would try to take one step, and a few more years went by. She went to school, and in school, she would see other kids playing sports. Somehow she got this feeling that she'd like to run. But everyone told her, you barely are able to walk, how are you going to be running? Especially in a race where there are other kids. But she told herself that she wanted to run. So when she was 13 years old, she put her name for one of the races in the school. So she went to the race and she came in last. But every race after that, there was in the school that she was eligible to go, and she would go and she would give her name. And everyone knew that she would come last, and they would kind of discourage her. Why are you going to run when you know you will finish last? And she finished last in one race, a second race, a third race, many, many races. She would always finish last, but she would always give her name for the next race. And so one day, she came next to last, second from last. And slowly, 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 in a few years, she was able to win her first race at school. And it is said that after she won her first race, every other race that she ran, and she started to win. And she went to college. And as she went to college, she wanted to be on the running team. As this life is talked about, one of the coaches saw what her determination was, and he started to coach her in the best possible of manners. She started to win all the races that she was getting in. And Olympics came around. And so her name was put into the list of people to represent the country in the Olympics. And she went to the Olympics, and she was running in the 100 meter dash. In that race was the world champion. And when the race finished, it was she who came first. She won one gold medal, she went to another race and won a second gold medal. And then she was in a relay race where four people are taking a baton and they are running to get to the end. And the one which was a champion before was in one of the other teams. So it is said that when this race started, the two people who were running the first two legs of the race chained the baton very nicely. So the first baton chain was good, the second baton chain was good, and the third one is now running. And she, this young girl, was the fourth one. But when the third one came to exchange the baton, it wasn't done properly and fell down. In the meantime, the one who was the world champion that time, their transfer of baton was very good, and so that girl was many steps ahead. But this young girl picked up the baton and ran and was able to win the race. So she had three gold medals, and we know her as Wilma Rudolf, one of the greatest Olympic runners. So let us not have any difficulty stop us. If someone says you're unable to do something, you know that the strength is within you. If someone says this is impossible to achieve, you know that if you work hard enough, if you put in the effort, you will be able to reach any height. You know, this pandemic is very, very difficult for many, many people all around the globe. We've been hurt in many ways, emotionally, physically, economically. Let us not succumb to this virus. Let us take this challenge and make some opportunities out of it. You know, we're all asked to stay at home. So let us use the time to know our families better. Let's spend more time with our children, with our parents, with our other family members, with our spouses, so that we get to enjoy each other's company more and more. Maybe previously, everyone's running around and didn't have the time to spend time together. So this is a great opportunity to enhance the bonding that we have within our own families. This is also a great opportunity to learn new skills. We know that with the pandemic, many things are changing. And so it might be good to learn a new skill at that time. There's so much information online that we could use to learn a new skill so that when this is over with, we're able to make a good living for ourselves. This is also a good time to enjoy our hobbies. Let's say we're very artistic. Let's say we enjoy music or any other hobby that we have. Now we've got more time to ourselves because we are not wasting time, you know, getting caught up in traffic. We're not wasting time just to be able to do those chores that now we don't need to do. So this is a good time to focus on what gives us enjoyment. Because it's the hobbies that truly, truly help us when we are going through any difficult state, whether it be physical or emotional. This is also a time to extend a helping hand to others. The realization that we're all connected, the realization that we're all one and the same, the realization that we're all part of this one big family of the Creator. This makes us get to a state where the pains of others become our pains so that we can extend a helping hand to them. Whether we are mentally astute or physically more powerful or emotionally more stable or financially we are more stable, these are times to be able to help others. There are many people who have a difficult time providing a meal to themselves. There are many people who need help to be able to deal with the emotional trauma that this virus has brought to many, many people. There is so much help that we can provide to others. And one of the greatest things that we can do at this time, and we can convert this challenge into an opportunity, is to truly focus on ourselves. To know who we are, to recognize what the purpose of this life is, to be able to find the strength within ourselves, to connect with the Creator. God the Creator is within each and every one of us. And those who connect with God are the ones who pass through life in a very calm and peaceful manner. So this time is a good time to use all the extra time that we have away from the time that we put into work, time that we don't lose in driving and other times that we don't lose in getting dressed up and everything else that we used to do before. And use that time to sit in silence, to meditate, to connect with the divine power within, to experience the divine light and sound of God. And as we experience that power within ourselves, we will find the strength which will be helping us overcome this challenge which is facing each and every one of us. So let us not worry about the challenge. Let us know that there's always light at the end of the tunnel. Let us know that we have the strength within ourselves to deal with any difficulty that comes in front of us. Let us home into that strength. Let us connect with that power. Let it permeate each and every pore of our being. And let us use that power to be able to overcome this difficult time that we all are passing through. So let us meditate for a few minutes. Please sit down as comfortably as you can. Close your eyes very gently, just like you close them when you go to sleep. Your eyeball should be straight, focused 8 or 10 inches in front of you. And as you close your eyes, those of you who are initiated in the mysteries of the beyond, please do your simran. And those of you who are new here, repeat any name of God that you feel comfortable with. Know that God is within you. Know that God is not far away. Know that to know God is not the domain of the saints and mystics only. That each and every one of us can know God. Just like the example of Wilma Rudolf. People said she's not going to be able to live, but she lived. Others said she's never going to be able to walk normally, but she did walk. No one thought she would run, but she ran. No one would imagine she could win a race, but she won many. No one would have imagined she would be an Olympic champion and win 3 gold medals, let alone one. So the power is within ourselves. We need to have faith in ourselves. We need to have faith in God. Let's have that faith in God and know that we can connect with God. So as you repeat God's name, let your attention be right in front of you. And light will shine forth as soon as your concentration gets to be better and better. I pray to God Almighty and to the 3 great spiritual masters of the past century, Hazur Baba Savan Singh Ji Maharaj, Param Sant Kripal Singh Ji Maharaj, and the gracious master Sandarshan Singh Ji Maharaj, to help each and every one of us here connect with the divine power within, have us experience that power, and have us experience the divine light in its effulgence. We will be sitting for a few minutes, and I'll be getting you out of this meditative state, and my best wishes are with each and every one of you.